Hello everybody, welcome to a smart grasp, explore and win. Greetings for the day. Let's get started with today's topic.
Chapter 3, coordinate geometry, exercise 3.1. In that, first sum, how will you describe the position of a table lamp on your study table to another person? So the question is about how we will be telling the other person about the position of a table lamp which is kept on our study table. We will usually say it in a fashion like the table lamp is in the left corner, right corner, something like that, right? So here the question is about how exactly we can say the position of the table lamp on our study table. So let's assume this is our study table and a table lamp is placed here. Now let's discuss how we will tell the position of this table lamp to the other person. In order to communicate it to an exact position, we can consider our study table as a plane with x-axis and y-axis. So let us consider the table as plane. In order to say the position exactly, we need to mark the exact location with the help of x-axis and y-axis. How our latitudes and longitudes are marked. So we will consider this as x-axis, this one as y-axis, and this be the origin O. Also, let us consider the corner of the table as origin, which we have already marked over there. Horizontal line as x-axis and vertical line as y-axis. So these are the things which we have discussed just now. Now, in order to know the exact position of this lamp, we need to know the distance here as well as this distance. This distance refers to y-axis, so y centimeter, and this distance refers to a value in the x-axis, so let it be x centimeter. So now the position of this lamp can be given by x, y. In order to point a position in a graph, we will have coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinate. The same way here, x, y gives the exact position of this lamp, where x is the distance from the origin to a value in x-axis and y is a distance from the origin to a value in y-axis, which gives the exact position of the lamp. Thus, the position of the table lamp is described by the ordered pair x, y. So, for example, let's consider this be the x-axis and this be the y-axis, and here comes the origin. For instance, let the horizontal distance be 4 cm and the vertical distance be 5 cm. However, the position of the lamp on the study table is x, y. So, it turns out to 4, 5. This is only because we have taken the x-axis and y-axis in this fashion, assuming that we are standing facing the table from this side. This 4, 5 can be changed to 5, 4 if we are standing and facing the table in the other side, whereas we will assume the x-axis and y-axis in the opposite way, in the vice versa manner. If at all I am standing facing this side, my x-axis will be like this and my y-axis will be this. So this 4, 5 will change to 5, 4 accordingly. We can say the position of the table lamp exactly based upon the position from where we stand and face the table. So in general, we can say the position by the ordered pair x, y. The value is related with from which position we stand and face the table and which axis we assume it as x and y axis. So let's conclude this with a statement. For example, if the distance of the lamp along the horizontal line is 4 cm and along the vertical line is 5 centimeter, then the position of the lamp is 4,5. It is not mandatory that we should take the same values as example. It is just up to us to take any values as an example to conclude the sum. Now let's discuss the second sum. Second sum. A city has two main roads which cross each at the center of the city. That is, there are two main roads like this. These two main roads cross each other at the center of the city. So this is the center of the city. Now these two roads are along the north-south direction and east-west direction. So these roads are in these directions. One is on the north-south and the other one is on east-west. And all other streets of this city run parallel to these roads and are 200 meter apart. So there are many other streets which are 200 meter apart from these main crossroads. North-south direction as well as in the east-west direction. There are 5 streets in each direction. So let's draw the other 5 streets in each direction, in both the directions of the street. So in the north-south direction, these are the 5 streets. Now in the east-west direction, let's draw the other 5 streets. 3, 4, and 5. Now we have 5 streets in the east-west direction as well. For our easier calculation, let's name the streets. Street 1, Street 2, Street 3, Street 4, Street 5. The same way in this direction. Street 1, Street 2, Street 3, Street 4. And street 5. Now the next statement of the question is, using 1 centimeter equal to 200 meter, draw a model of the city. So we are supposed to use the scale 1 centimeter equal to 200 meter, and we have to draw the map of the city just as we did now. The only thing is, we have to take measurement like 1 centimeter distance between each street, because they have asked us to take the scale as 1 centimeter equal to 200 meter. Since two streets are apart from each other with 200 meter difference and the scale is 1 centimeter equal to 200 meter, we will draw the 5 streets in each direction with 1 centimeter apart. So we have to represent the roads by single line like we have did just now. So let's mark the distance also from the main street. So this is 1 centimeter apart. This is 2 centimeter apart from the center. This is 3 centimeter apart. 4, 5. The same way in the other direction as well. There are many cross streets in your model. Yes, of course, there are many cross streets in our model. Each and every point is a cross street. A single cross street is made with the help of two streets, because when two streets meet, we will have a cross street, that cross point or the intersecting point. So one in the north-south direction and the other in the east-west direction. So we get the cross streets when these two roads meet at a single point. Each cross street is referred in the following manner. Let's look how they are referring it to us. If a second street running in the north-south direction and fifth street running in the east-west direction. So this is the second street, this is the fifth street. So this particular cross point. This particular cross street is referred to as 2,5. That is what given in the question. Using this convention, find They have given two subdivisions. First subdivision is how many cross streets can be referred to as 4, 3. Here the first value 4 refers to a street number which runs in north-south direction, because in the 2, 5 the first value refers to the street number which runs in north-south direction, and the second value refers to the street which runs in the east-west direction. The same way here, the first value refers to the street number which runs in north-south direction, and the second value refers to the street number which runs in east-west direction. So the point is 4th street, here 3rd street. That is this particular point. So let's mark it as point A. The point A which refers 4, 3 is unique. That is a unique cross street as shown by the point A 4, 3. There are only one cross street can be represented by the point 4, 3. Now second subdivision 3, 4. The same as first subdivision. The first value refers to north-south direction street. The second value refers to east-west running direction street. Now let's look into the model. Third street here and fourth street in this direction. That is this point. Let's mark it as B. This particular point is also unique. Therefore, a unique cross street as shown by the point B, which is 3, 4. So here we are referring the cross street with the help of two different streets which runs in two different directions. Hence, we cannot have a same single point referring two or more cross streets. Each cross streets are referred by different points. Hence, with this, we have completed this exercise.
Thank you all for watching SMART. Grasp, explore and win. Stay tuned for more videos.